I felt that Avalon was as far as I could take the kind of Roxy thing. I felt that it was one of the best albums we'd made, and it was kind of one of the most complete albums we'd made. And it was very hard to top it in a way without some kind of radical changes. And yet there is some sort of continuity between this album and that, I suppose. I think half of the players just about are the same. But there are lots of new ones as well. I think there are about 30 musicians on this record.
30?
Yeah.
At any stage, could this have actually been a Roxy Music album, though, Bryan?
No. I don't think so. I don't know what you mean. well, yeah, I suppose it could have, the same songs could have been done with the Roxy people, I suppose. Yeah.
But you felt that that wasn't to be?
Yeah, I felt I'd gone as far as I wanted to go with the thing as it was.
Why was that?
Personality difference, you know, clashes really. Not musical differences as such, which is always the time-honored reason for groups sort of breaking up. I just felt we've been together for such a long time, and I think we probably all got, at the end of it, got on each other's nerves quite a bit, you know, as people can do. And just normal human differences, you know. But sometimes it makes you feel a bit sad, you know, to think that that name, which I spent, you know, a long time building up together with the others, is sort of finished. But I think it's better to push forward. And even though there is obviously a certain security in a group name, and a lot of groups stay together for a very long time, you know, like old dinosaurs, for the wrong reason, because they simply have this banner of the name, and it becomes a sort of product. And I don't think you should make music in that way, or any kind of art should be made under those sort of conditions. You know?
Obviously, with an album out, the next step has to be to tour, doesn't it? Do you anticipate touring?
No, not with this record. I've spent so long making it that I think it would be a mistake for me really to go on the road just like that. I'd rather really do a few kind of television show things or whatever, and then start making the next record. And maybe next year, which I hope to a little bit more quickly. And perhaps next year be in a position to do a tour, you know, with maybe two albums to a repertoire, as well as, you know, earlier songs as well.
What motivates you now then? I mean, in terms of your art, what actually makes you, drives you on?
Well, it's very hard to pin down what it is, you know. But it's always the thing of wanting to do something better than you've done before. And you just build up this body of work over the years, which you hope gets better and better, you know. It's a kind of, obviously it's a self-discovery thing, apart from anything else.
On what merits do you hope Boys and Girls is going to be judged?
Oh, I think the musicianship is really good. I think it's well produced. And the guy I work with is Rhett Davis, who I've worked with for the last few albums. And I think we've got a very good team now, who work together very well. And when my kind of enthusiasm flags, his is always there to keep both the thing up and keep it going. And so it's very well recorded, you know, the whole thing. It's well put together. These things I know. Yeah. I hope that the song's all right. It's very hard for me to be objective about them now at this stage. Maybe, you know, in a year or so. At the moment, I feel it's like the best thing I've done.